So a 1 year course is not a disadvantage, but again, it depends on which department you're in. I think the question was for MEng in chemical. So I know one person who's done his MEng in chemical from ICT, and he was saying that having work ex for him also mattered because a lot of students, a lot of master students in chemical engineering end up doing PhD because there are not a lot of opportunities in terms of work for chemical engineers. But having said that, definitely try your luck at getting a job and try to, I mean, I would say try to diversify. If you're a chemical engineer, do try to take courses from other departments and try to like have a multi-departmental sort of like a mixture, like somewhere between electrical and chemical or mechanical and chemical, because that would help you enter a lot more other industries. But having said that, a 1 year course is not a disadvantage because your course has been designed in such a way that you finish it early and you start hunting for jobs. So accordingly, every career fair companies will know what to expect from a student who is doing a 1 year course. It's not a disadvantage, but again, it's just very tough. I mean, it gets very, you have to finish a lot of credits in less time. So that way it might be a bit tough, but other than that, I don't see any problem. And if you're coming to Purdue, I don't think it's a problem. The BAIM course is, I think it's a pretty impressive course. You can take subjects from marketing analytics, supply chain analytics, supply chain management, data analytics, information engineering. There's a lot of courses and a lot of specializations inside the BAIM field that you can take. And a lot of seniors that I know in the BAIM field have, like I mentioned, they have work ex and they are now looking to diversify. So they take up courses in data analytics, which are like a It's like a fresher, it's like a brief course on using various software such as R and Python and SQL for data management, database management, and predictive modeling, stuff like that. It helps you a lot. It is definitely a very good course. I would definitely say it's a very good course. But like I mentioned, the courses there are like half mod. So you have to take two courses at least, which will be like the first mod and the second mod, because if you don't, from March to May, you are doing nothing. So accordingly, you have to decide which course and decide what specialization you want. Job opportunities for BAIM is also not bad. Students like BAIM is a part of the Cranard School. They have their own career fair. So companies that come to that career fair are looking to hire people from the BAIM field. So that's not a problem at all. I mean, for mechanical engineering, it's a very big department. A lot of professors a lot of reputed professors, and you have a lot of. I think if you're going to mechanical, you might be a thesis student, and every thesis student does get, or at least has a good chance of getting funding in terms of TA-ships or RA-ships or not. If not that, just a grader position, and then just converting that to a TA-ship later. But again, it depends on your research interests. It depends on how much work you actually want to put in. In terms of careers, mechanical engineering is not that great. They have to sort of go to every career fair, like even the Cranard career fair. They'll have to go to the industrial career fair. All they have to basically go to all career fairs where companies are willing to hire international students for mechanical engineering, which are not as many. A lot of students I know from my college themselves who have gotten a co-op, and one of them is in Bonbo and one of them is at Lennox Technologies. So it's not bad. You can definitely get a chance for a good co-op and internship. Just make sure that you're willing to like be better than your other classmates in terms of work ex or on-campus work or thesis work or anything, research work, so that you can talk about that at the career fair. Yeah, definitely. If you want to specialize in data analytics, and if you want to take up some good CS and statistics course, then please take up some courses such as R or Python, SQL. These are basic languages that they use here. And also brush up on your C, C++ skills. try to have like a good Java background. If you don't have these, it's totally fine. You can come here and learn those as well. But if you do have time back in India, please take these courses. They are a great boost for any students who are looking to apply directly when they come here for internships. You can talk to a lot of companies about the certifications that you have, and if you have like an identifiable advantage to these companies, then they will definitely prefer you over students who have not taken these courses. So I think Purdue is a great school. It's definitely very diverse, a lot of Indian students here. It's very safe in terms of academics. Also, there is no course that you will find disappointing, or I mean, you might find it a bit tough, but at the end of the day, you will end up liking the course. Just make sure that you have a good friend around you. Just make sure that you have that you get in touch with your seniors and you speak to them about which courses they took, about what opportunities and how that they took, and potentially going forward, how can you make the most out of the resources that you have. And just try to make, I mean, don't just stress yourself out on all these academics and internships. There are like a lot of good facilities on campus where like the sports facility, I think it's one of the biggest sports facility in America. It has facilities for every sort of sports. And it's free for students. So try to do as much as you can, because this is, I think, one of the only experiences where you're going to be like sort of chilling with your friends and stuff like that. After this, once your full-time opportunities begin, you literally don't even get like 10 holidays in a year. So try to go out, try to, if you're coming to America for the first time, try to explore, try to travel as much as you can. Just enjoy your life when you're in America. Just don't like be busy and stressed out all the time.